This is America Weekend. I'm Mike Bennett. Naturalist and farmer Greg Quinn is responsible for bringing the black currants back to the U.S. market and, in fact, grows black currants on his farm in the Hudson Valley, New York. And it's time now for his notes from the current farm.
I'm Greg Quinn. Welcome to this week's Notes from the Current Farm. From a farmer's perspective, this has been a pretty good year so far. The winter was cold enough for the currants to set their buds, and while our rainfall was several inches short throughout much of the spring, some good soakers recently have really helped the crops and wildflowers grow. The milkweed will be blooming in about 10 days. Milkweed is the common name for a genus of plants called Asclepias, named after the Greek god of medicine and healing. The many beautiful milkweed varieties have a myriad of medicinal properties, including cardiac glycosides. The real value of milkweed for me, however, and should be for anyone concerned with nature, is that this group of over 100 varieties of plants is the only food source for the caterpillar stage of the monarch butterfly. As the monarch larva consumes the milkweed leaves, it retains the cardiac glycosides, making the monarch toxic to predators. The monarch butterfly is probably the most recognized of all butterflies in North America. Its trademark orange, black, and white wings, while beautiful to the human eye, is a warning sign to predators, and this delicate, colorful creature will be poisonous to all those on the hunt for the next meal. The amazing thing about the monarch is its life cycle. While it populates all areas of North America in the summer, most of them spend their winter roosting in a small mountainous area in Mexico. Imagine for a moment this gossamer creature weighing 1/4 of an ounce, negotiating winds, storms, and whatever else nature throws at her, traveling up to 100 miles a day to journey 3,000 miles to their winter home each fall. But that's not even the most amazing part. The monarchs, returning from Mexico in the spring, will breed as soon as they find the first milkweed plants in the southern U.S. They lay their eggs on the plants so that the caterpillars will have a ready source of food when they emerge. The parents die shortly thereafter. These new larvae will then go through the miracle of metamorphosis, ending with a new generation of butterflies, and they will continue the journey north following the blooming milkweed. This second generation then breeds, and the cycle begins all over again with the resulting third generation, following the milkweed blooms north. They go up to 4 generations during the summer, each living only 2 to 6 weeks, except for the last. At the end of the summer, the adults, now as far north and as widespread as Washington State, Michigan, and Maine, know there will be no more milkweed for another generation. So instead of breeding, as their parents and grandparents had done, they turn around and somehow know how to get back to the exact mountains in Mexico that their ancestors left 3 generations ago and 3,000 miles away, and without GPS. There has been a great concern in the past years about the dwindling population of the monarchs returning each year. This may be partially linked to climate change, but the noticeable change in the environment is the drastic decline of all species of milkweed. Many large-scale farmers, as well as maintenance crews along highways, developments, golf courses, and corporate parks, use herbicide to control weeds, and milkweed is killed along with all the others. Without milkweed, there's no food for the caterpillars, and so very limited reproduction. The population has been crashing. I haven't seen a monarch butterfly here on the current farm for over 3 years now, and they used to be abundant. I make sure that there's plenty of milkweed in my wildflower fields and brushy areas, but if there's little milkweed south of here, these miracles of nature won't make it up this far. Some people feel like there's not much you can personally do that will directly help the environment, but here's an area where each one of you can make a difference. Many seed companies sell milkweed seed specific to your part of the country. If you have suitable property, plant milkweed seed. If not, plant it along roadways, in abandoned fields, or in any sunny area where it will not be disturbed. Many people feed the birds. Why not feed the butterflies? It's a really small investment to keep this beautiful, amazing animal off the list of endangered and extinct species. For a podcast of this and previous notes from the Current Farm, and to visit America's number one source of black currant products, go to currants.com. That's currants with an A.
And with Greg Quinn, naturalist and farmer, I'm Mike Bennett, and you're listening to America Weekend.